Would you believe me if I were to tell you that yours, 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 and even yours, everybody's life, everybody's, and I mean everybody's life, is under a big threat? Would you believe me? Probably not. You'd probably say, come on, dude, you survived everything. Floods, nukes, COVID. What is that that is threatening us that much? Well, I bet you didn't see that coming, because you cannot see it, literally, and you probably haven't heard of it or thought of it as a threat. Ladies and gentlemen, meet fungus. One of the biggest yet strangely unknown threats to us humans. And if you're laughing, yes, that's a typical response, and yes, it sounds funny, because fungi are so tiny, and there's no way they can be dangerous to us humans, you might say. Well, when I say fungus, a lot of people immediately imagine of some kind of mushrooms, like this one right here. And if you're doing so, you're not wrong. You're actually correct. Except, fungi are not mushrooms, but mushrooms are fungi. Meaning, there are millions of other types of fungus out there. Now, I'm sure at least a few people here have a basic understanding of what fungus is. But still, let me tell you about it. Fungi are what I like to call a third kingdom living organisms. And in order to reproduce and continue their life cycle, they need a host, a body, in which they can grow and eventually reproduce. We do not know much about them. We've discovered numerous benefits of them, as such LSD lights that you can get from ergot, psilocybin, which are fungus, or penicillin that you can get from another type of fungus called Penicillium chrysogenum, or the yeast that is effectively being used in beer and wine production. And it's not all. Listen closely. Some scientists are currently working on some specific types of fungus to produce what is likely to be cancer cure. Mind-blowing, isn't it? It is. However, there's still a lot to be discovered about fungus. It is to us humans, they look harmless enough. A lot of species know otherwise. The thing is, some fungi do not seek to kill their victim immediately. They seek to control it. And that way, one single fungus is able to take down entire ant colony, for example. As a matter of fact, ants are the main victims of fungus in the tropical rainforests. Now, let's go a little deeper into the infection process. After the infection, everything might look normal for the first week or two, because obviously, fungus needs time to grow. But once fully grown, it just travels through the circulatory system of the ant, gets to their brain, fills it with hallucinogens, and thus bends the ant's mind to its will. Fungus starts to direct ant's behavior, telling it what to do, where to go, like a puppeteer with a marionette, if you can imagine it that way. And it gets worse. Fungus needs food to eat, so it begins to devour its host from within, replacing its flesh with its own. Horrifying, isn't it? But it doesn't let its victim die, no. Keeps its puppet alive by preventing decomposition. And at the end, it will all look something like this. Ooh, horrifying, isn't it? It is, yeah, but it's still ants. How exactly fungus is dangerous to us humans, you might ask. Watched a movie called The Last of Us? Could you please raise your hands if you have? Thank you very much. I see a lot of people did not. Okay, for anybody who did not, basically a fungus called cordyceps starts infecting people and turning them into monster-looking zombies. So I wondered, could that really happen to us in real life? And by the way, that movie is actually the reason why I started my research and why I'm standing here talking to you about fungus. And the short answer for the previous question, there's actually no short answer for this question because views are pretty controversial. Some scientists believe that it could still happen, while some believe that it's extremely unlikely due to a multitude of reasons. Whether it's going to happen or not, it's definitely not going to happen in a way. Yeah, this is, by the way, The Last of Us. Don't forget to watch it. Yeah, in the movie, you see mushrooms growing out of the skull over the faces of infected people. See? This is not going to happen to us. I hope. But the apocalypse could still happen. See, this is funny because some scientists believe that fungal outbreak is already underway with an emergence of this guy. Candida auris, a fungus that has been discovered in 2009 in Asia and has spread around the world ever since. A lot of people call it a serious global health threat. But according to other scientists, like Dr. Andreas Beck from Washington University, having this sort of catastrophic fungal outbreak is extremely unlikely. But he reminds us that if that happens, it's going to be significantly scarier than anything humanity faced before. For example, COVID. Since COVID can travel through relatively small areas, while fungal spores can travel miles, he says. So, $1 million question arises. Should we really be worried about that? I mean, if it was that serious, scientists would have probably warned us about it, right? Well, ladies and gentlemen, my job is to inform you, and you decide whether to worry or not. As of now, lucky for us, there are only 600 types of fungus that can infect people, and only 500 of them can cause disease. And only 100 of those 600 are classified as primary pathogens, meaning that they can make you ill, any one of you, even if you are a completely healthy individual. So only 100. Other, more dangerous types of fungus cannot survive if the host's internal temperature is over 34.4 degrees Celsius, meaning that they cannot survive inside the human body yet, yet being the keyword. There's no reason for fungi to evolve now, but you see, the global warming is happening, and our beloved Earth is getting warmer and warmer, decade by decade. Now, that's a decent reason to evolve, I believe. What do you think? If that happens, and if they evolve and be able to withstand higher temperatures, us humans will automatically become a potential target for fungus. You know what happens next? You know what happened to that ant I told you about? The one that has been infected? So, it became a zombie. It went on to infect its brothers, sisters, other ants. The exact same thing could happen to us humans. One person will be infected, he spreads the infection to other people, and it continues until they reach millions, billions. Now, let's be clear. I'm not saying that fungus is going to control your mind and kill you, no. Theoretically, it's impossible, because our bodies are structured completely different than those of insects. However, infected person might still feel some changes in their behavior, or might get seriously ill. So, what do we do? We obviously don't want this to happen, do we? No. What do we do? Or should I say, what can we do? Well, nothing. There's nothing we can do. No cures, no preventatives, no medicine. It's impossible to create them. That's what professor from the movie said, but as you can see, I am not a professor. So I've been doing my own research. I've been searching the net for a while, and I found out pretty good things worth to tell. And as it turns out, fungi are not that dangerous now. And the only ways you can get infected is if you use contaminated items such as clothes, beddings, come in contact with fungal spores, or mistakenly eat poison products like mushrooms. So naturally, in order to avoid infection, we have to be careful. We have to wear shoes in locker rooms, community showers, don't walk barefoot, especially in the wet areas, and bear in mind, avoid using shoes that are made out of plastic that don't breathe. Follow a good hygiene. Wash your hands regularly, especially after touching other people, animals. Avoid using other people's towels or other healthcare products. Stop biting your fingers, and no matter how weird it sounds, change your socks. Yeah. And last but not least, at least try to prevent global warming. So there's no reason for fungi to evolve. Thank you very much.